Dobrodošli u drugu epizodu Srpski glumci u stranim filmovima. Danas ćemo govoriti o čuvenom srpskom glumcu Mladenu Sekuloviću, u Americi poznatijim kao Karl Malden. Karl Malden je rođen u Americi 1912. godine, ali je već od ranog detinjstva imao dodira sa srpskom kulturom, zahvaljujući svom ocu Petru Sekuloviću. Njegova glumačka karijera započela u pozorištu, 30. godina, gde je upoznao reditelja Elija Kazana, u čijim je filmovima kasnije stekao popularnost. Učestvovao je u Drugom svjetskom ratu, a 50-ih kreće u usponu njegove glumačkoj karijere. Glumio je raznovrsan set likova, a u tom periodu se istekao u filmovima Tramvaj zvani želja i Na dokovima New York. Prvi mu je donao Oscara, a drugi nominaciju u kategoriji najbolje sporedne uloge. Iako je imao sjajnu karijeru, nikad nije stekao status superzvezde, što on objašnjava činjenicom da je glumio različite tipove likova, od manijaka pa do onih koji se bore protiv nepravde. Vrhunac slave stiče tek 70-ih u seriji Ulice San Francisco, gde je glumio sa tada mladim Michaelom Douglasom, kome je bio veliki uzor. U Beogradu je 2018. godine ispred Jugoslovenske kinoteke otkriven spomenik Karlu Maldenu. Tada se Michael Douglas putem video poruke obratio prisutnima i izrazio svoje veliko poštovanje prema svom prijatelju i mentoru.
My dear Serbian American friend, my mentor, Mladen Sekulović. But I'm so proud that he's getting this beautiful statue in his home country today. I had the privilege of working for 4 years with Carl. 6 days a week, 8.5 months at a time. Carl and I did 104 hours of television together, and he truly was my mentor. I learned everything from Carl. Carl had two daughters, but I was his adopted son. I'll never be able to thank Carl enough for teaching me about the art of listening to other people. He had a work ethic next to none, and he was a lovely, lovely man to boot. My thoughts are with his beautiful wife, Mona, who is still with us, and to all of his Serbian friends. I'm so supportive and thank you so much for this honor to Karl Malden. A great, great man.
Pošto je bio ponosan na svoje srpsko poreklo, često je svoje ime i prezime Mladen Sekulović podmetao u različite filmove i serije. Tako u filmu Patun, u ulozi generala Omara Bradleya, kaže jednom vojniku, dodaj mi taj štajm Sekuloviću. U filmu Na dokovima New Yorka, jedan od likova na suđenju se zove Mladen Sekulović. U filmu Dead Ringer, kao policijski detektiv, kaže drugom detektivu, daj mi moju kapu Sekuloviću. U ulozi policijskog poručnika u seriji Ulice San Francisco zapošljava pomoćnika Sekulovića. Kao zatvorski čuvar u filmu Birdman of Alcatraz čita listu zatvorenika, a jedan od njih je Sekulović.
Malden is not your birth name, is it?
No, it's not. My name is, can you pronounce it? No, Mladen Sekulović.
Mladen Sekulović.
Yes, right. It's a Serbian name. And I changed the A and the L in Mladen and made it Malden. Mm-hmm.
And you've actually, you've worked the name into some of your movies.
Many films, and in Streets of San Francisco, there's a cop called Sekulović.
You just always like to put it in, have someone put it in the script somewhere, just as a reminder.
They don't put it in the script. They don't know I'm doing it.
Oh!
They don't know I'm doing it. They come in, many times the script girl will say, you said something, what did you say? I said, Sekulović, how do you spell it?
And you would just work it in?
I just work it in. There was one place I had a tough time working in Birdman of Alcatraz with, mm-hmm. With Burt Lancaster. Mm-hmm. I couldn't, there was nowhere I could say it. I was the warden of Alcatraz, and I had a hard time putting it in, so finally I thought, I'll put it on one of the cells.
So they think there's a prisoner there.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So I went to the prop man and says, put Sekulović up on one of the cells. He did, and as I went down, I said, Jones, Smith, Alex, Sekulović, and went down the way. And suddenly about, when the movie was released, my dad called me up and says, let me tell you, son, Sekulović was never in prison.
A sada, slede zanimljivosti.
U srednjoj školi je igrao košarku, a tokom igranja je 2 puta povrijedio nos. Povrede su se ispostavile kao dobra investicija jer je mnogima prepoznatljiv upravo zbog ogromnog nosa. Malden se oženio 1938. godine i u braku je bio sve do smrti 2009. godine. Kada je riječ o dužini braka, u pitanju je treći najduži brak u istoriji Hollywooda. Imao je 2 ćerke, Milu i Karlu Malden. Karla je ko autor njegove autobiografije Kako sam uspeo. Dugi niz godina učestvovao je u realizaciji reklame za American Express, a ovo mu je jedna od boljih.
This man has worked a long, hard day and he's got a lot of money to show for it. Other people's money. He's a pickpocket. His take, $700. It's dangerous to carry cash. Carry American Express traveler's checks. If they're lost or stolen, you can get them back. Your vacation is protected. American Express traveler's checks. Don't leave home without them.
Sve do vrtića, Carl Malden nije znao da priča na engleskom jeziku. Bio je blizak prijatelj sa glumcem Brad Dexterom, zvijezdom filma Sedmorica veličanstvenih, koji je također srpskog porijekla. Posle smrti svog oca, odlazi u Jugoslaviju gde obilazi rodno mesto svog oca kod Bileće. To se pokazala kao odlična prilika za domaću kinematografiju. Pomogao je da se realizuje film Gorana Paskaljevića, Suton, iz 1982. godine.